I would like to create a universe.
Universe, huh? Noble cause. How are you going to finance it?
Cosmos.
Infinite in vastness.
Stretching out in all directions.
Filled with nothing but gas and dust. Until, in a part of this insignificant galaxy.
On an insignificant planet.
A significant thing occurred. For on that tiny planet was born a new creation in the universe.
Life.
Ah! This life was not limited to a solitary form. It flourished. And creatures of all shapes and sizes roamed the earth.
But of all the life forms on this planet, man was supreme. For he was given the drive that no other animal had. The drive to learn.
Anga Banga?
From the beginning, economics determined who could learn and who could not. Those who could flourished.
Those who could not learn.
The winds of time passed, and man's essence of knowledge was increased. By the Egyptian age, working to direct his own destiny, the collection of knowledge begins. Knowledge preserved for centuries in ancient pyramids and tombs.
Pharaohs, Egypt's rulers, were immortalized in royal tombs to preserve their regal splendor.
The Golden Age, Greece. A time when man's art and science flourished, as well as his ability to theorize and think. The great philosophers emerged with new ideas and concepts.
Ah, I've discovered a way to pay for education, and I will call it financial...
Rome, the pinnacle of the Golden Age. A mighty empire, Rome could teach its people and create learning institutions. In its own short-sightedness, however, Rome fell. Leaving in its wake an array of ignorant tribesmen and savages. This quickly propelled Europe into the Dark Ages.
Knowledge and higher learning came to a halt. It wasn't until the dawn of the Renaissance that man learned again.
The church was responsible for much recorded knowledge and financed education.
It provided higher learning along with higher buildings.
And cathedrals. Man was ready to learn again, even if the birds were not. The march of time went on, and so did man's need for knowledge. Life was more complex, and he had to learn faster. He was becoming more mechanized and more industrialized. The 20th century was approaching. Education was available if one could afford it. By the turn of the century, millions migrated to America in search of prosperity. They became more educated. By the 1920s, a new level of sophisticated man existed.
Today, almost everyone is seeking a higher education in one form or another. Students of all ages are going to school. More and more people are attending universities, vocational classes, community colleges, and other such institutions in numbers far greater than ever before.
With this increase of students, there exists the ongoing struggle to pay for this increase in education. Fortunately, financial aid offices offer several options to students to help them finance their education. Unfortunately, these options have created a plague of new problems. Ask any student who recently has tried applying for financial aid, as we did.
I knew I needed money for college, so I went in to find out about getting financial aid. When I went into the financial aid office, I didn't know what to expect. I mean, there were other kids in there. They were filling out papers left and right. Then someone asked me what I wanted, and I told him money for school. The next thing I knew, I had a stack of papers in front of me. So I started filling them out, one by one. Gosh, it took me forever. I thought I'd never get finished. Luckily, I adjusted to it. But some of my friends never did. They just haven't been the same since.
This student has requested that we keep his identity anonymous.
I started out like everyone else. I couldn't afford college, so I decided to try to get aid. I entered the office innocently trying to fill out some application, you know, like you'd expect. And I finished several forms, but they kept giving me more. I'd fill them out too, but then they needed more information. I thought I could handle it, you know. I finally got out there, and I got out of there, and I tried to shrug it off. And I was okay after a day or two. And then a month later came the forms. They were verification forms. So I filled those out again. But now I knew something was wrong. I could no longer control it. My friends noticed the change, too.
He was so easygoing. A really nice guy. You know, we'd go out together and have some fun. Then slowly, he started to change. He started asking me strange questions like, where did I live? When was I born? What was my earned income? Was I a dislocated homemaker?
It got even worse. I began filling out surveys, questionnaires, business reply cards, anything I could find, you know? Anything I found with a blank space on it. Even my own bank dropped my account after I went into the bank to write a withdrawal slip, and I filled out every withdrawal slip in the bank. I mean, what a mess. I knew then I was hooked. I am a form addict. I started drifting from town to town, and just to go through the formality of registering again. You say to yourself, it won't happen to me. Before you can stop, you're hooked.
Alas, financial aid had progressed over the years, but still had its imperfections.
Students were plagued with a roller coaster of paperwork.
Some felt the procedures used to select students for aid was unfair.
Students were still intimidated at the thought of applying for aid.
I think financial aid's a real headache.
Amen.
I get so discouraged. Sometimes I feel I can't get any loans or grants.
I do not like financial aid. I find it such a monstrous... Oh, look! It's got zero!
Fortunately, financial aid procedures are slowly starting to change. Students are able to apply for aid quicker and easier. Applications can be processed faster.
Financial aid offices can now offer many more aid options to students to help pay for their education.
With the addition of today's computer technology, financial aid is finally becoming
in touch with the future.
I would like financial aid, please.
Please insert your student ID into the computer, see?
Thank you very much.
Yeah, see?
And so, as we come to the end of our historical misadventure, it is with high hopes and great expectations that we will see a brighter tomorrow in the cause of financed education.
Now, I don't like it.
What don't you like?
It's sappy, it's corny, it doesn't make sense. It's a greeting card you'd send to your grandmother.
Well, what else do you expect? We're coming to the end. This is the end of the whole thing. We're wrapping the whole thing up. We're giving thanks to the people. What's wrong with my grandma?
Listen. It's something everybody would expect. It's like have a...